Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Mystery of the Secret Chamber. Chapter 1. The Enigmatic Castle. In the heart of medieval Spain, where history's echoes reverberate through the cobblestone streets and ancient structures, a castle stood as a testament to the enigma that gripped the region. Dr. Alejandro Ramirez, a distinguished historian known for his relentless pursuit of historical truths, found himself drawn to this fortress cloaked in mysteries. Nestled atop a rugged hill, the castle's imposing silhouette seemed to beckon him into a realm where the secrets of the past were guarded with utmost secrecy. As Dr. Ramirez embarked on the journey that would bring him face to face with the Inquisition's hidden chamber, the Spanish landscape unfolded like a living tapestry of history. His quest began in the medieval city of Toledo, renowned for its labyrinthine streets and the convergence of cultures that shaped the Iberian Peninsula. The echoes of bygone eras resided in the city's ancient architecture, whispering tales of religious conflicts, political intrigues, and the shadow of the Inquisition. Guided by cryptic manuscripts and obscure references, Dr. Ramirez followed a trail that led him through a maze of medieval streets. The city's rich history seemed to seep through the very stones beneath his feet, heightening the historian's anticipation as he approached the castle. The path to the enigmatic chamber was obscured by layers of history, challenging Dr. Ramirez to decipher the clues left behind by those who sought to keep the secrets buried. As he ascended the hill toward the castle, the medieval edifice loomed larger, its stone walls weathered by the passage of centuries. The castle's battlements, once formidable defenses against external threats, now guarded a far more insidious secret, a chamber concealed within the depths of the fortress, known only to those initiated into the dark recesses of the Inquisition. The castle's gates, weathered and time-worn, groaned as Dr. Ramirez pushed them open. The historian's footsteps echoed through the expansive courtyard, where remnants of a forgotten era lay scattered like fragments of a puzzle, waiting to be reassembled. The air was thick with the weight of history, and the castle seemed to hold its breath, as if wary of the intruder seeking the hidden truths within. Navigating through the labyrinthine corridors, Dr. Ramirez encountered relics of the Inquisition's past: torture chambers, interrogation rooms, and ominous portraits of inquisitors who once wielded power with ruthless determination. The castle's stones seemed to absorb the residual energy of the horrors that transpired within its walls, imparting a palpable sense of unease to the historian's journey. As he ventured deeper, Dr. Ramirez discovered hidden passages and concealed alcoves, each revealing fragments of the castle's clandestine history. The walls whispered stories of clandestine meetings, covert operations, and the pervasive fear that gripped the inhabitants during the height of the Inquisition's influence. The secrets guarded within the castle's confines resonated with the collective trauma trauma of those who had suffered at the hands of the merciless inquisitors. In a dimly lit chamber concealed behind a tapestry, Dr. Ramirez uncovered a hidden door adorned with symbols that hinted at esoteric knowledge. The door, seemingly untouched by the ravages of time, presented a formidable barrier to the historian's quest. Drawing upon his expertise in historical symbolism, Dr. Ramirez deciphered the intricate patterns, revealing the key that would grant him access to the Inquisition's most guarded secret. As the door swung open, revealing a passage leading into the heart of the castle, Dr. Ramirez felt a surge of anticipation and trepidation. The air within the concealed corridor was thick with an otherworldly energy, as if the secrets of the Inquisition's hidden chamber were about to be unveiled. The passage led him through subterranean depths, winding and twisting like a journey into the annals of a haunted history. The culmination of Dr. Ramirez's journey awaited him as he approached a heavy, iron-clad door. The very threshold of the Inquisition's hidden chamber seemed to vibrate with an unsettling resonance, amplifying the sense of foreboding that surrounded the historian. Steeling himself, Dr. Ramirez pushed the door open, stepping into a space that transcended the confines of time and space. A repository of artifacts and secrets that bore witness to the darkest chapters of Spain's medieval past. Chapter 2: The Whispering Forest. The journey through the enigmatic castle had left Dr. Alejandro Ramirez with a profound sense of foreboding. As he stepped into the hidden chamber, the air itself seemed to thicken with the weight of centuries-old secrets. The artifacts within spoke of a dark past, and the historian couldn't help but wonder how these relics connected to the legendary forest he had heard whispers about. A mystical woodland said to guard its own secrets and serve as a bridge between reality and the supernatural. Leaving the castle behind, Dr. Ramirez ventured into the heart of medieval Spain, where the legendary forest awaited. The landscape changed from the stone confines of the fortress to the sprawling wilderness beyond its walls. Towering trees formed a dense canopy overhead, their gnarled branches intertwining like ancient guardians, protecting the secrets buried within the woodland. As he delved into the forest's depths, Dr. Ramirez felt an otherworldly energy enveloping him. The air seemed charged with mysticism, and the play of sunlight filtering through the foliage created a dance of shadows and light. The path ahead, dappled with sunlight, revealed glimpses of moss-covered stones and symbols etched into the bark of ancient trees, a cryptic language that spoke of the forest's connection to forces beyond human comprehension. The forest's silence was broken only by the rustle of leaves and the occasional creaking of ancient branches. Dr. Ramirez moved with a sense of purpose, guided by the whispers of the woodland. It wasn't long before he encountered symbols resembling those found in the castle, a convergence of historical markers that linked the two mysterious locations. As he ventured deeper, the forest seemed to come alive with ethereal echoes. The whispers of the woodland became an intricate tapestry of ancient tales, entwining with the very fabric of the landscape. Dr. Ramirez, attuned to the symbiosis between nature and the supernatural, recognized that the forest held the key to unraveling the enigma that spanned the castle and the legendary woodland. In a secluded glade, bathed in the soft glow of filtered sunlight, Dr. Ramirez discovered a clearing adorned with stones arranged in a pattern that mirrored constellations above. The celestial alignment seemed to echo the significance of the symbols etched throughout the forest. A realization dawned upon him. The Whispering Forest was not merely a repository of secrets, but a conduit for energies that transcended the earthly realm. Guided by the celestial patterns, Dr. Ramirez continued his journey, each step revealing more of the forest's mystical tapestry. The trees, ancient witnesses to centuries of untold stories, bore scars in the form of carvings and symbols, echoing the castle's cryptic inscriptions. The convergence of symbols between the forest and the castle hinted at a profound connection, an intertwined history that linked the supernatural to human actions. As daylight waned, Dr. Ramirez stumbled upon an ancient altar hidden beneath the twisted roots of an ancient oak. The altar, adorned with offerings of long-forgotten rituals, held artifacts that mirrored those within the castle's secret chamber. It became evident that the forest served as a living record, a custodian of the past, preserving the echoes of rituals that bridged the realms of the mundane and the supernatural. In a moment of epiphany, Dr. Ramirez recognized that the forest wasn't merely a backdrop to the castle's secrets, but an integral part of the enigma. The trees, the stones, and the symbols etched into nature's canvas were conduits for energies that transcended human understanding. The Whispering Forest, once perceived as a separate entity, now emerged as a collaborator in the intricate dance between history and mysticism. With newfound clarity, Dr. Ramirez retraced his steps, acknowledging the interconnectedness of the castle and the forest. The journey through the legendary woodland had not only unveiled the forest's secrets, but had woven a tapestry that connected the supernatural forces at play. As nightfall descended upon the mystical landscape, Dr. Ramirez felt a sense of gratitude for the revelations bestowed upon him by the Whispering Forest, an ally in his quest for the truth that transcended the boundaries of time and space. The moon, a silent witness to the unfolding events, cast its silvery glow upon the forest, transforming it into a realm where the past and present coexisted in harmony. Dr. Ramirez, filled with a profound sense of awe, emerged from the woodland with a deeper understanding of the interconnected forces that governed the castle's hidden chamber and the mystical heart of medieval Spain. Chapter 3: Shadows of the Inquisition. Having unraveled the mysteries of the Whispering Forest, Dr. Alejandro Ramirez found himself standing at the threshold of the next phase of his quest. The forest's revelations had shed light on the interconnected history of the mystical woodland and the enigmatic castle. But the shadows of the Inquisition still loomed large. As he continued his journey through medieval Spain, the historian delved deeper into the annals of the Inquisition's dark past, seeking clues that would guide him to the clandestine chambers hidden within the castle's confines. Dr. Ramirez retraced his steps, returning to the cobblestone streets and towering structures of Toledo. The city, once a bustling hub of cultural exchange, now seemed to carry the weight of centuries-old secrets. The Inquisition's presence lingered in the very air, a haunting reminder of an era marked by religious fervor and ruthless persecution. His quest led him through forgotten catacombs, where the whispers of the Inquisition's tormented souls echoed through dimly lit tunnels. The catacombs, a labyrinth beneath the city's surface, held the scars of the Inquisition's sinister interrogations. Dr. Ramirez, guided by historical texts and cryptic maps, navigated the subterranean passages with a sense of urgency, each step bringing him closer to the shadows that concealed the true nature of the Inquisition's activities. As he explored the depths of the catacombs, Dr. Ramirez discovered hidden chambers adorned with symbols that mirrored those in the castle and the whispering forest. The walls seemed to close in, as if bearing witness to the sins of the past. Torture devices, remnants of a bygone era, stood as silent sentinels, testifying to the Inquisition's relentless pursuit of control and dominance. The shadows cast by the flickering torchlight painted an eerie tableau, a macabre testament to the depths humanity could descend in the name of faith. In his relentless pursuit of the Inquisition's secrets, Dr. Ramirez unearthed manuscripts that detailed covert operations and clandestine rituals. The Inquisitors, veiled in shadows, had left behind a trail of cryptic writings that hinted at a deeper layer of the organization's activities, a hidden tapestry woven with threads of esoteric knowledge and forbidden practices. The historian's research led him to forgotten dungeons where the Inquisition's victims had suffered unspeakable horrors. The damp, cold air seemed to carry the residual anguish of those who had faced persecution within these dimly lit cells. Dr. Ramirez, grappling with a mixture of sorrow and determination, recognized that the shadows of the Inquisition extended far beyond the physical boundaries of the dungeons. They reached into the very fabric of Spain's medieval history. Amidst the dim glow of candlelit corridors, Dr. Ramirez stumbled upon a chamber containing ancient texts and scrolls that spoke of the Inquisition's collaboration with entities beyond the mortal realm. The forbidden knowledge hinted at a dark alliance, an unholy covenant forged in secrecy. The historian's heart raced as he deciphered the coded language, realizing that the Inquisition's pursuits were not confined to earthly dominion, but reached into the realms of the supernatural. Driven by a fervor to expose the Inquisition's darkest secrets, Dr. Ramirez ventured into the hidden alcoves where Inquisitors had conducted forbidden rites. The walls bore witness to esoteric symbols, intricate patterns that resonated with the energy of rituals that sought to harness otherworldly forces. The historian, confronted with the revelation of a shadowy alliance, felt the weight of responsibility to bring these hidden truths into the light. As Dr. Ramirez emerged from the depths of Toledo's catacombs, he carried with him the knowledge that the Inquisition's shadows extended beyond the physical structures that housed its malevolent activities. The forest, the castle, and the catacombs were interconnected nodes in a vast web of history, each revealing a different facet of the Inquisition's pursuit of power. The journey through the shadows of the Inquisition had unveiled a narrative of complexity, a tale of intertwined destinies, where the forces of the earthly and the supernatural converged. Dr. Ramirez, standing on the precipice of revelation, understood that the final chapter of his quest awaited within the hidden chambers of the castle, a convergence of history, mysticism, and the shadows that bound them together. As the moon cast its silvery glow over the medieval city, the historian steeled himself for the imminent unveiling of the Inquisition's darkest secrets. Chapter 4, The Unveiling. The moon hung low in the night sky as Dr. Alejandro Ramirez stood before the imposing ironclad door, the final barrier between him and the revelations that awaited within the hidden chamber of the medieval castle. The whispers of the forest and the shadows of the Inquisition had guided him to this pivotal moment, where the secrets of centuries were poised to be unveiled. Summoning the courage that had propelled him through the labyrinthine landscapes of medieval Spain, Dr. Ramirez placed the ancient key, acquired from the forest's sacred altar, into the lock. The metallic clink of the key turning resonated through the silent corridor, sending a shiver down his spine. The door, with a slow and eerie creak, swung open, revealing a passage that seemed to extend into the very heart of darkness. As he stepped into the concealed chamber, Dr. Ramirez was met with an otherworldly scene. The room, bathed in the soft glow of ancient torches, was adorned with symbols that mirrored those found in the forest and the catacombs. The air carried a charged energy, a fusion of mysticism, and the lingering echoes of the Inquisition's malevolence. The artifacts within the chamber were arranged with deliberate precision, a macabre tableau that told a story of forbidden rituals and unholy alliances. Dr. Ramirez, guided by his historical acumen, began to decipher the symbols etched into the walls. Each carving seemed to narrate a chapter of the Inquisition's clandestine collaboration with supernatural forces, unraveling a narrative that transcended the boundaries of mortal comprehension. In the center of the room lay a stone altar, upon which rested an ancient tome bound in leather that seemed to defy the passage of time. The pages, inscribed with cryptic runes and esoteric symbols, hinted at a pact between the Inquisition and entities from the beyond. Dr. Ramirez, with a sense of trepidation, opened the tome and began to translate the arcane language within. The words on the pages spoke of rituals conducted under the cloak of secrecy, where inquisitors invoked powers beyond the mortal realm. The forest, with its whispering echoes, played a role as a conduit for energies that fueled the Inquisition's ambitions. The shadows of the catacombs held the residue of rituals that sought to manipulate the very fabric of reality. As the historian delved deeper into the forbidden knowledge, he uncovered a revelation that shook the foundations of his understanding. The Inquisition's pursuit of supernatural forces was not fueled solely by blind zealotry, but driven by a calculated desire for dominion over the realms unseen. The artifacts in the chamber, each imbued with a dark energy, seemed to pulse with the echoes of rituals that had transcended the boundaries of morality. In the dim light of the chamber, Dr. Ramirez noticed an ancient reliquary placed upon a pedestal. The reliquary, adorned with symbols of celestial alignment, held an object of profound significance, the key to the Inquisition's unholy alliance. It was a fragment of a relic said to contain the essence of a celestial being, a being that had been invoked to grant the Inquisition dominion over the supernatural. As Dr. Ramirez touched the relic, a surge of energy coursed through him, carrying with it visions of the forest, the catacombs, and the tortured history of the Inquisition. The relic, a conduit for the celestial being's essence, connected the historian to the very forces that had shaped the destiny of medieval Spain. In a moment of revelation, Dr. Ramirez understood that the forest, the catacombs, and the hidden chamber were nodes in a cosmic web, a tapestry woven by forces that transcended human comprehension. The celestial being, once invoked by the Inquisition, had become a prisoner of its own essence, trapped within the relic as a testament to the arrogance of mortals who sought to harness divine energies. As he stood amidst the artifacts and symbols that bore witness to the convergence of history and the supernatural, Dr. Ramirez felt a solemn responsibility. The secrets unveiled within the chamber were not merely a chronicle of the Inquisition's malevolence, but a cautionary tale of the dangers that arose when mortals sought to control forces beyond their understanding. With the relic in hand, Dr. Ramirez exited the hidden chamber, the weight of the revelations settling upon him like a heavy cloak. The moon, now high in the night sky, cast its ethereal glow over the medieval castle, a silent witness to the unraveling of secrets that had endured for centuries. As Dr. Ramirez emerged from the castle's depths, he carried with him not only the relic, but also a profound understanding of the interconnected forces that had shaped the course of history. The forest, once a whispering guardian, and the catacombs, a repository of the Inquisition's shadows, had become integral parts of a narrative that transcended the boundaries of time and space. The historian, guided by the celestial relic, returned to the forest, where the echoes of the Inquisition's secrets began to dissipate. With a ceremonial ritual, he sought to release the celestial being from its ethereal prison, allowing it to return to the cosmic forces from whence it came. The forest, now cleansed of the malevolent energies, seemed to breathe a sigh of relief, a testament to the delicate balance that existed between the mortal and the supernatural. As dawn approached, Dr. Ramirez stood at the edge of the whispering forest, gazing into the horizon with a sense of fulfillment and solemnity. The secrets that had gripped medieval Spain had been unveiled, and the historian, with the relic in hand, now understood the responsibility that came with such knowledge. The cosmic tapestry, intricately woven with threads of history and mysticism, had been revealed, and Dr. Ramirez, with a heart heavy with the weight of revelations, emerged from the shadows of the Inquisition into the dawning light of a new understanding.